Hello everyone, this is Srinivas here. In this video, I'll be showing you the Eclipse shortcuts which I've often used while working on test automation. So I think this will also help you in some way when you are working with Eclipse. Now first of all, why we have to go for shortcuts? We have to go for shortcuts from Eclipse because it will help us speed up the coding. So we can use shortcut keys to write the code faster. Okay, so now let's discuss few of the shortcuts which I've used very often. Now starting with the first shortcut, that is Control 1 Enter. Let me show you through example. So I have created one, I have a script here, and in this script, so I am doing driver.findElement by.name, something like that. So this is a web element. Let's say I want to store this in a variable. So in manual, when we are typing it manually, what we do is we store it like we'll say web element equal to, like that will do, and then I'll say element dot click. If it is a button, I'll say element dot click. So instead of doing all this, so now in a single shortcut, I'll show you from Eclipse how we can do. So you can just declare the right hand side. You can write the right hand side, that is driver dot find element by dot name. After that, place your mouse pointer in the semicolon. Okay, so in the semicolon, you can place the mouse pointer, and then type Control 1 Enter from the keyboard. So when you do that, automatically it will assign the output to the variable, and it will have the variable name defined. So if you want to change the variable name, you can change it accordingly. Let me do it again. So I'll just have the right hand side written. Anything it could be. So whatever expression you are writing, so just write that expression, and to the right of semicolon, just place your mouse pointer and then say Control 1 Enter. So when I'm doing Control 1, okay, I can see that it is showing two options. So one is assign statement to a new local variable, assign statement to new field. Okay, so these are the two different things. So if I say assign to field, it is something like this. So it will define a field, and then it will store that in a first it will create a element, a variable, and then it will assign it to that particular variable. So this way, or other way, if I just select it directly, it will store that, it will directly initialize the variable to the value what you are going to create. Okay, so let us use this first option. So when I say Control 1 Enter, it is going to do that. I'll say Control 1 Enter. So now we can see it is done. Now let me try the other option. So when I say Control 1, and I'll select this option. So when I've selected, we can see that there is a private static web element declared at the top, and that expression, that field has been set with value here. So this way, we can use it very effectively, Control 1 Enter, to store the value of the expression in any variable automatically. Now the best part is Eclipse will automatically find out what is the expression variable type to be. So if the expression variable type to be integer or long or string, it will automatically store it in that respective variable. Okay, so like in this case, it has identified the output is going to be in web element form, so it has stored in web element. Okay, so this is the one. And now second shortcut we are going to discuss is formatting. So what happens is we keep writing a lot of automation code, and sometimes what happens is, you know, while fixing some issues, we do not put the parentheses in the right place, or we don't give the tabbing and things like that. So again, it would become additional burden for us to go and, you know, manually tab and, you know, format the code accordingly. So instead of doing that, in Eclipse, the simple shortcut that is available is Control Shift F. When we do it, it will automatically format, auto formatting. Now let me just show it to you. So this is one of the sample code I have. In this, it is not in the proper formatting. There is no tabbing followed, tab is not followed. So let me just say Control Shift F here. And now we can see that it is properly formatted. So this is very useful shortcut, Control Shift F. Okay, and now let us see the third shortcut. That is about renaming the variables. Now let me come back to my previous script. Okay, here, and in this script we can see that we have declared web driver, driver equal to new Firefox driver, that is the reference variable used across, and that driver has been used till the end of the code here. We can see that it is used till the end. So now let us say that for some reason, okay, you have to rename this reference variable to something else. Okay, so we go and we try to modify it here. So then it will have to be changed in all the places. So then what is the other alternative? I need to say control F, find and replace. I need to do all those things. So instead of doing all that, so if I want to rename it, and that rename whatever I'm doing, I want it to be reflecting in all the lines of code further. Okay, if we want to have it like that, then how we can do? So we can simply have that variable selected, and then we can say Alt Shift and R. So when we do that, so now you can see that the driver which I have highlighted, all is having that small rectangle covered, and I can change it to driver. I'll change it to browser driver. Okay, so just I'm changing it to any variable whichever I want to change, and then after I have done the changes, I need to press the enter. So when I press the enter, you can see that the driver in small letters got replaced with the browser driver, and that reflection has happened throughout the code, so there is no need to again modify for me. So this is the third shortcut we have discussed. So in this we have followed Alt Shift and R. Okay, so this is very useful shortcut to rename. Okay, now next let us see the shortcut with respect to Content Assist. So Content Assist, most of you already may know. So you don't know the exact name of the method or the class, then you can simply type a few letters and then you can say Control Space, that is shortcut from Eclipse. When you say that, it will give you the suggestion. It will give you the suggestion, and based on the suggestion, you can select whatever you want. For example, now let me say that I am typing this code. Let me say I am typing this code, actions. I am saying action, something like that. When I say Control Space, I can see that it is suggesting actions. So this is Content Assist. So Content Assist is useful in while writing loops and all also. Like suppose you are very new to Java and you are writing a loop and you want to write a for loop, then instead of typing the full for loop, if you want to see how does the for loop syntax looks like, you can simply use this option. For, I said, and then I said Control Space. So it is showing us all the options. So I have selected for iterate over array. Here you can give the array size, or you can say array dot length. For example, I say int a. Okay, so let's say our array is of size 5. Okay. Okay. So then I can say here a dot length. So this way, this for loop using Content Assist I could do. Similarly, I can show you here. Now let's create a new class just to quickly show you. I mean, where and all it is useful. I'll say test new, just new class. And in this class, let's say you forgot to define the main. So you can say Control Space and it will show you the suggestion select. And so that way it has created the method for us automatically, so by using the content assist. So that's very useful. And now next, let us so that was Control Space, so that is very useful. Now let us move on to the next shortcut. Next shortcut is with respect to the methods. So now let's say you are writing a big class having a lot of methods, or maybe you have implemented this method long time back, or this class has been implemented by someone else, and now you want to find a particular method, you want to go to that particular method, but lines are huge, like 1000 or 10,000 lines of code. So then instead of scrolling down and searching, there is a simple shortcut provided in Eclipse that we can use to go to a particular method. You can simply use Control O shortcut, and that will open up and it will show you all the methods and instance variables for us, and we can use that window, small window which is open. We can choose whichever we want to go to, and whenever we select it, it will go to that particular method or instance variable. For example, if I want to go to this print engine number, I can simply select print engine number. It has gone to this particular method. Okay. Again, control O. And here one more thing you can see. You can see all the instance variables. You can see it with different icons. You can see the methods with the green color. And you can also see if it is a static method, you will see with the S letter. If it is a final method, you will see with the F letter. Okay, that way we will know what type of method that has been created and we can use it for specific purposes. Okay, so this is about control O, open particular method. So that is used. Now, one more shortcut which I want to show you, that is control shift and T. So if you use this, so this is useful for us to find out what are the classes that are available in our project. So it includes all the libraries that you have imported in the project also. So now let's say I want to check actions. So if I want to see whether actions class is available, so in this project, that is Java training project which I have currently, there is no Selenium library imported, so it is not showing the Selenium based actions. Now let me go to the other project, that is web automation, and in this project let me go to one of the class and then I'll say control shift T. So this is the shortcut which will help us find out the classes that are available in the project. So it is also inclusive of the libraries that are imported. Okay, so now let me say actions. So it has to show us control shift T. And now let me first check actions again. So now let us see actions. I'll scroll down. Yeah, we see it here. So it has the actions class displayed. Similarly, now I have created my own custom classes like test3. I want to search test3 is there or not. It searches in all the packages in the project. So it will show you this is available in this particular package. So it is showing test3 is available in test cases package. So this will help us find where exactly it is very easily. Okay, so that is used. Again, the shortcut is control shift T. So now, by the way, when I was doing that, when I was selecting, I can search for some other class also. Let me select web element. Okay, now let us see here. It also shows interfaces, by the way. So now here we can see that it is coming from three different it is showing in three times because I have imported I have three projects in which I have imported Selenium library, three or four projects. That is why it is showing repeatedly. So if you have a single project, then it will show you only once. Okay, so and also you would see from which library it is coming. If I have selected this is from APM library, Java client 6.1.0.jar. And I can see that here also down, we would know from which library it is showing that particular class or interface. Okay, that is about control shift T. Okay, and now let me go to the one more shortcut, that is alt shift S. So this is very useful shortcut. Now let us come to one of the class. Okay, let me, I think I need to create, let me create one class. Okay, and I'll just define employees. Okay, and in this class, let me define an int employee number. Okay, and I'll say string emp name. Okay, just for us to know. Okay, like this, in your Selenium class, in your project, you may have some instance variables created in class. Okay, and general practice in automation or in coding, okay, general practice that we follow is we create getter and setters to access the variable information or to set the value to the variable. So there is a shortcut available. Instead of writing the getter and setter manually, like you know, for the respective instance variable, there is a simple shortcut available. We can just use Alt, Shift, and Yes. So when you say that, It will show you again list of shortcuts, but we will be focusing on the particular shortcut for the getter and setter. So just say Alt Shift and Yes. So when you say that, it will show you the option generate getters and setters. So when you select that, it will open a window for you. In that you can select for what all instance variable you want to generate the getters and setters. Select that, select the access modifier for it. Let's say in this case I want to have it public, and if you want to generate comments, you can generate comment also. Then you can say okay, and now you can see that it has generated four methods, that is two getters and two setters for respective instance variables which I have created. So it's so fast. So within within few seconds I could create this and I could reuse for my further coding purposes. Okay, so that's the very useful shortcut. And finally, last shortcut which I want to show you about the commenting. So for commenting single line, you can use Control Shift C, which will comment a single line. So this is one way of commenting. Now if you want to comment multiple line, you can do the same thing. You can have multiple lines selected and you can say Control Shift C, and that will comment this way. So this is doing using two forward slashes. Okay, now let me say Control Z and it has uncommented. Now if you have blocks of lines, okay, so if you have blocks of lines and you want to give the block comment, instead of using Control Shift C, you can use Control Shift and forward slash will put the comment for the selected line, starting with the one forward slash star and forward slash for the ending. Okay, and you want to remove this comment. Let's say in the future you want to remove the comment, select the block and then say Control Shift and reverse backslash. Okay, reverse slash you need to put, I mean that is backslash. So to put the comment, you can say Control Shift slash, Control Shift forward slash, and Control Shift backward slash will remove the comment. Okay, so this is about commenting and about commenting. And finally, last is when you have some compilation error, okay, and you want to fix that compilation error, so you can simply say Control 1. So basically Control 1, let me just show you. Okay, by the way, Control plus is to increase the font, Control minus is to decrease the font. It is not going to help us anyway. I mean, you will have some standard font set, just in case if you require, you can use that. So, and we can say whenever, let me just create some error. And whenever we get the error, right? So to fix the error, we can simply say Control plus one. So that is this. So whenever we have some error, that is compilation error, you want to have it fixed, you can say Control 1. Okay, Control 1 is the command that will give you annotation. Annotation is, it will give you some suggestion. It will give you some suggestion. For example, let's come here and let's see here, Control 1. Okay, so it is giving some annotation. So this way it will help us in some way. Okay, so these are the major shortcuts which I have used in while automation in my project. So I hope this short session has been useful to you. Thank you for watching.